Greetings, viewers at home. My name is Vusumuzi Victor Nkosi from Ehlanzeni TVET College. Campus is Kanyamazane campus. The program is Engineering and Related Design. The subject offering today will be Engineering Fabrication Level 2. So the topic will be topic 4, which is oxyacetylene cutting. Right. Let me explain firstly what is oxy. In full, it's oxygen, and the other one is acetylene. So oxygen is the compressed air in a cylinder. That's oxygen. Acetylene is a gas. It's a gas that's combusting with oxygen to do the cutting. All right? Oxyacetylene cutting is extensively used for cutting material for required size and shape. It's also used by the welders for joint preparation for the plates, which are thicker than 16 millimeters. You can also use it to remove unwanted metal or defective weld. Right, we'll look at the components of oxyacetylene. So our first component we are going to discuss about is acetylene. Acetylene is a flammable gas. The cylinder of acetylene is usually painted maroon and is fitted with the left-hand thread. That is acetylene. And the pressure, it is compressed at about 1,700 to 2,000 kilopascal. It's also fitted with the temperature sensitive fuse. In terms of fire, that fuse will escape what the acetylene from the cylinder and prevent it from causing damages. And the acetylene, another thing, acetylene must always stand at an upright position. Never use acetylene lying down. So it's very much important. So now, we will discuss now about the oxygen. Okay, oxygen also holds air at the higher pressure. It have got the cylinder valves and the safety cap. The oxygen cylinder are usually painted black. And the pressure, you remember I said the acetylene is 17, and here the oxygen is 17,000 to 20 kilopascal. Right, another component is the regulator. Let me show you the gas regulator. This is the gas regulator. So I've picked up what the acetylene regulator. You simply identify it by its color. You see the color of this one is red. If it is red, it means it's acetylene. So the acetylene have got two gauges. Here's the gauges of acetylene. It have got two gauges. The one is showing what is inside the cylinder. And the other one is showing what the working pressure. Right. The gauges we've got another gauge, which is oxygen. The oxygen differs, it will be blue in color. That is oxygen. So what is the main purpose of the regulators? It reduces the high cylinder pressure. It reduces the high cylinder pressure to the desired pressure for cutting. You remember I said in the cylinder, it's in the higher pressure. For you, you can't use that higher pressure. You have to regulate it to your pressure, which you must use for cutting, right? And another component I want to discuss with you is the torch. We call it a cutting torch. This is the example of a cutting torch. This is a cutting torch. Some other people call it a blowpipe. If you may find me referring it as a blowpipe, it simply means it's also what? A cutting torch, right? It have got this tip. This tip is for putting what? The nozzle. It's for putting the nozzle. right? The combination of this one, if you look closely, this one, it represents what? The oxygen. When we are pressing this one we call it the liver. And when we are pressing this one, the oxygen goes through this one, and the oxygen goes again through this one for heating, and acetylene again this one. Then this portion of an acetylene is the handle. This is the handle of the cutting torch. These ones, we call it the flashback arresters. They are flashback arresters, and they are also fitted inward in the blowpipe. So the difference now of oxygen and acetylene, you see the color coding here. Here is bluish and here is red. So if it is bluish, it means when you tighten it, you tighten in a clockwise direction. That's a clockwise direction. If you tighten this one, it's an anti-clockwise direction. That's the difference of the two, right? So the cutting torch, this one is the other type of a cutting torch. It's little bit shorter than that cutting torch I've shown you. It also have got the color coding. Then I've got this one. This one is not a cutting torch. It's a welding torch. It's usually used by those guys who are welding exhaust. They use what? This. You just simply change what? The nozzles. You simply change the nozzles so that you can do the welding. But for now, we won't discuss about this one. We'll just discuss about the cutting torch. Right. Right, another component which we must discuss about is the nozzles. This is your nozzle. This is your nozzle. The nozzle, it have got what? The orifices. It got tiny holes. Let me draw it. That's the nozzle. It have got tiny holes. 1, 2, 3, 4 holes. And at the center here, there's another hole. That hole is for the oxygen, for cutting. If you can check it exactly, this one. So this one, it differs in sizes. I will explain to you just now what will be the sizes and how it differs with the other ones. This one, these holes, it obviously is for heating. It's for heating the metal plate. Right, so we've got what? The nozzle cleaner, because once again, when you are doing what you're cutting, your nozzle will get dirty. Once it gets dirty, it won't cut accurately or nicely. So you have to use what? The nozzle cleaner. This is your nozzle cleaner. So the nozzle cleaner have got pins like this. You put it in like in the center orifice where you clean your nozzle. You clean your nozzle. When you do another cutting, it will be perfect. Right? Then now let's discuss the full components now, the whole components of oxyacetylene cutting. You remember I discussed about the regulators, I've discussed about the cutting torch, I've discussed about the flashback arresters. I've left out what the horses. This one we call it the horses. They are the horses. They are also color-coded. The red one represents acetylene, and the blue one represents what? The oxygen. So if you are fitting it, you fit the oxygen, the red one on the oxygen section, the red one on the acetylene section, and the blue one on the oxygen section. Right? Let's check now how to do the assembling of oxyacetylene apparatus. Remember, I said to you, both cylinder should stand at an upright position. So it means for assembling, all your cylinders should be on an upright position. And it should be tightened, ensure that it's secured, is properly supported. How can you support it? By putting what? The chains around them. Once it is secured, then now you can open each valve. You start with the acetylene. You open the valve just once to blow out what the dust which may be trapped in the thread. Then after that, you can screw in what? Your regulator. You can screw in your regulator to the cylinders. You can screw in the regulators. It depends which regulator you are screwing in. If it is acetylene, remember, is a left-hand thread. You screw it anti-clockwise. Right. Once you have done with the connection, remember the connection, be sure that if it is acetylene, it's on a red, and if it is oxygen, it's on a blue. Then after you have connected the regulator, you can now connect what? The hoses. From connecting the hoses, you can connect what? The blowpipe with the required nozzles. Right. Now, once you have connected, you can now light up the torch. You can light up the torch. For lighting the torch, first thing you must do, you open the cylinder valves and check for leaks. You open first the cylinder valves, you check for leaks, whether there is leaks on your pipes or leaks on your fittings. If you suspect something, use a soap. A soap will show bubbles. The bubbles, it will tell you that there is a leak. So try to fasten that particular fitting. Right. Then once you have done that, you can now open what? On the cutting torch. Start with the cutting torch. You can open now the acetylene. You start with the red one. It's connected now. I've got the hoses and everything, and it's connected to the cylinder. I open first the acetylene. Yes, and open. Then I light it with the lighter. I light it. It will show what? It will show a flame. The flame have got a soot. A soot, in other words, it have got what? The smoke. It will show a smoke. I will adjust this acetylene valve up until the smoke disappears. Once it disappears, then now I can open what? The oxygen. I open the oxygen. I adjust the light up until it's a neutral flame. Right. Then once I've done that, I can do what? I can start the cutting. But when you are doing the cutting, it's very much important. You must be able to know the sizes of the plate that you are going to cut. It's very much important. Once you know the size of the plate, so you can be able now to select what the type of the nozzle you want to use, because there are different types or different sizes of nozzles. You have got from 0.8 up to 3.2. So the 0.8, it refers to the inner one, the diameter of the inner one. It can be 0.8 if you want to cut a 3.6 millimeter thick plate, 3 to 6 millimeter, or you can even cut up to 150 to 200 millimeter thick plate using what? The cutting torch. It depends on your adjustment. So if it is bigger, like your 250 millimeter plate, so you have to do the adjustment on what? You use this screw to adjust what? The pressure which you require. So the pressure for this one will be 450 for oxygen. Then for acetylene will be 35. Once you set it correctly, you will cut up to 250 millimeter plate. And it depends on your speed. How fast is it? If it is thick, you have to be slow. If it is thin, you have to be a little bit faster when cutting, right? So remember, I talked about the flames. There are three different types of flames that we have. Once you have lighted, you have light your torch, you will recognize three flames. It's a carburizing flame. If it is a carburizing flame, it tells you that oxygen, it tells you that acetylene is more than oxygen. If it is a neutral flame, it tells you that oxygen is equal to acetylene. And if it is an oxidizing flame, it tells you that oxygen is more than acetylene. So there are special applications where you can use what? An oxidizing flame or a carburizing flame. For example, the oxidizing flame, if you want to weld copper, most of the welders are struggling to weld copper. So for welding copper, you use what? An oxidizing flame, right? Let's check now for the quality purposes. The quality purposes, once you have cut through your metal, once you have cut through your metal, there is vertical lines. If you cut it correctly and your pressures are correct, your line will start showing like this. It will be straight lines like this. But once your cutting torch is closer, because the maximum, yes, your cutting torch, yes, your blowpipe. So the maximum distance between the cutting torch and the working plate should be 3 millimeters. It's 3 millimeters. Once it's higher than 3 millimeters, it won't cut correctly. It will show something like this. It means your nozzle is higher than 3 millimeters. Once it's lower than 3 millimeters, so it means you see these lines, it will come closer. It will come closer. It means your cutting torch is high. I'm through with this section now, topic three. So now let's check what the assessment activities. So we are given a figure of this component. We are given a figure of this component. Unfortunately, as I told you, there's color coding. Unfortunately, here you are not shown what the color coding, but the question is saying, state the name of the equipment that is shown above. You must state the name of the equipment. What is that equipment? Is a regulator and a gauges. It's a regulator with gauges and gauges. That is the equipment. So you state 1.1. This is 1.1. Then 1.2. State the name of the equipment that is shown above. That is 1.1. 1.2. State two functions of the above equipment. They need two functions, whereas we have got three functions of this device. So function number one, it reduces high cylinder pressure to a desired pressure. It reduces high cylinder pressure to required pressure. That's function number one. That is function number one. So function number two, let me say this is A, this is B. So function number two, it allows different working pressure to be selected for a variety of application. It allows different pressure to be selected. It allows different pressure to be selected for a variety of application. A variety of application. I'm sorry. Application. That is the two functions of the above equipment. There's another function, which is the third one, which it ensures a steady flow of gas pressure without variation and regardless of the cylinder pressure. Right. Now, question number two. During a flame setting process, backfiring occurs. What is backfiring? So, backfiring is when the torch is starting to make a noise. That noise, it shows that it's backfiring. It means now the gases are going through your pipes. That is backfiring. So they are saying to me, I must illustrate by means of a neat sketch is how oxidizing and neutral frames differ from each other. Right. That is 2.1. So A, the oxidizing flame, let me draw it to be a little bit bigger. This cone, it shows you is a little bit shorter. It shows you that is what is the oxidized or it's a neutral flame. That's a neutral flame. So the oxidizing flame, your oxidizing flame, the cone also will also show you that it's a little bit longer and is sharp. That is what in oxidizing. That's an oxidizing flame. So these are two different flames. It's the inner part or the inner core that differentiates the two flames. Then number three, illustrate by means of a neat sketch how the following surfaces looks like if the nozzle is held too high from the metal being cut. Right? That is 3.1. So your structure, if it is high, your structure will be like this. It shows that it's too high. Your nozzle is too high. If it is too low, then your structure, you see the vertical lines, it will be closer to each other. It will be closer to each other. It shows that the nozzle is closer to the metal plate that is being cut. Thank you very much for staying tuned. If you have any question, you can direct it to www.ehlanzenicollege.co.za. That is our website. Or our Facebook page is Ehlanzeni TVET College, and our Twitter is @EhlanzeniTVET, and our YouTube is Ehlanzeni TVET College. Thank you very much.